हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर पीसी कंबोडिया, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश, बीएसआर, गवर्नमेंट आर्ट्स कॉलेज, अलवर, राजस्थान। दिस वीडियो क्लास इज फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ एमए फाइनल इंग्लिश लिटरेचर पेपर फर्स्ट, प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ क्रिटिसिज्म और लिटरेरी थियरीज। इन दिस class we take on to the topic function of a tragedy. Tragedy is a play which is dramatized on the stage and its ending is sad or unhappy. Tragedy, as Aristotle says, is there when we copy the action of men in average better than general. If we copy the action of the men better than average, then how tragedy will happen? Because his understanding is better, his intellectual level is better. His tragedy happens only because of his error in judgment. He proceeds, but he fails to take appropriate judgment at appropriate timings. Say, for example, any miscalculation in business may lead to tragedy of a high-class merchant. Say, for example, if someone invests thinking that the prices of such and such stock will go up and he will gain profit, but on the other hand, the prices of the stock which he accumulates with his reserve amounts falls terribly down, then it is his miscalculation that leads to his tragedy. Then, when we are witnessing tragedy in a theater, then tragic pleasure is there. We know that when tragedy is going on, at that time, murder is there, bloodshed is there, violence is there. And in ancient Greek tragedies, there were the scenes of blinding himself. Say, for example, Oedipus blinding himself. And then Jocasta is there, which is not ready to continue with his life. So such scenes, when they are enacted upon in front of our eyes, we know that a false imitation of the same is going on, but still, how those tragedies will lead tragic pleasure is a question. But the great teacher Aristotle says that when we are executed in proper way, the scenes of horror, then those tragedies, they emit pleasure. That pleasure is tragic pleasure. It controls our emotions. It purifies our emotions. And pity is there, fear is also there at the same time. We have the feeling of pity if the person undergoing the tragic impact is not our relative. But the moment we come to know that such and such incident can happen to us also, then that pity changes to fear. It compels us to go into such a horrific atmosphere. And then there is the changing over of that pity in fear. Aristotle talks about these two terms, pity and fear. He also talks about a term that is catharsis. Of course, this term has not been explained by him in his first book of Poetics. Some critics, they say that in the second book of Poetics, that is second volume, he explained catharsis, but unfortunately that second part of that book is lost. Catharsis is the term which is related to tragic pleasure. Catharsis has been interpreted differently by different critics. They say that when we visualize or witness tragedy, then it disturbs the equilibrium, balance of our emotions. Emotions are already there within us. Say, for example, anger, pity, fear, joy. All these emotions are there, but there are certain unwanted emotions. Say, for example, dishonesty or the loss of morality. When we witness tragedy, then all these emotions are set to new equilibrium or new balance. Qualitative and quantitative changes of these emotions are there within us. The emotions which are unwanted are thrown out, and those emotions which are needed, they are set in. This way, tragedy is purification of our mind as well as heart. It is a moral conditioning. And in order to understand that moral conditioning, we will have to take another analogy or parallel comparison of our air conditioning, where temperature is regulated by maintaining air pressure, humidity, and the other factors. Similarly, the balancing of the emotions is needed. That balancing of emotions is controlled by tragic pleasure that we have while witnessing a tragedy when we are inside the theater. So tragic pleasure also has its own importance. I.E. Richards explains this catharsis. Humphrey House also explains his theory regarding catharsis. And there are other annotators who have differently interpreted, but all of them agree that the function of tragedy is to create a kind of pleasure, that is tragic pleasure, as said by Aristotle, and it balances our emotions. Say, for example, if we are suffering, then that suffering increases our pressure of emotions. By telling our feelings or our mental pressure, by puncturing our mental pressure, by telling it to others, we feel lightened. The burden of our mind and heart is removed. Similarly, when we witness tragedy, our emotions are overflowing. People start weeping, and then tears are there in the eyes. With those tears, their mental pressure is also lightened and they feel relieved. This way, tragedy removes unwanted emotions and purifies our mind and heart. This is the function of tragedy, and tragedy involves tragic pleasure, and tragic pleasure is also related with catharsis. We shall be taking some other topic in our next video class. Thank you so much.